Jamaica has a history of excellence in the sprints. And every year, the best boys and girls line up to prove who are the country's next rising stars. So it's time to hop on a plane and head to Kingston, Jamaica. This is a runner's weekend at Champs. Yo, what's going on? Landed in Kingston, Jamaica last night. Today though, just got on a bus, got dropped off by the water. We're gonna go for a run. I'm here with Puma to watch Champs this weekend. It's gonna be a lot of fun. And they brought in friends from all over the world. Let's go for a run, get some shakeout miles in. Carla.
Morning,
Ryan. Morning. We got Palabra de Runner over here. What's going on? Good to see you. Tommy, Jeremy Miller's here. Adam, Mika. Also, the fast runners in here. And it's hot, guys. Let me tell you, it's hot. It's like 80 degrees and humid at 9 o'clock. That was great.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
All right, guys. A little under 5 miles for today.
I know.
It's hot. All right, guys, all showered up now. Had a quick breakfast. Now we're gonna hop on a bus and then a boat. And then we're heading to a special island for some island time. Should be good. It's a hot day out there today. Island, normally known as Lime K, had everything. There was Jamaican beers, a steel drum player, plenty of food, coconuts, which are filled with way more liquid than I was expecting, and even Usain Bolt stopped by. I even had the chance to ask him a few questions. Usain, thanks so much for spending some time with me today.
Right.
Can you help explain for my American audience why the Boys and Girls Champs was so important?
Oh my God. I think in Jamaica, it's for the boys and girls, it's like their Olympics. You know what I mean? It's massive. It's schooling in school. It's massive rivalry. Kingston College, JC, Calabar. So it's just such a big rivalry that everybody looks forward to every year. And it only gets bigger and more intense every year because you get a bragging rights for a year and you want to retake it. So, and it helps to turn out a lot of athletes, and that's how you see so much talent.
All right. For the boys and girls that are lining up for the 100 meters this weekend, what is going through their minds? Can you help me understand? What are they thinking about?
For me, it comes back to the same thing, bragging rights, because when you see the emotions that they come out as young kids, they see each other all the time at different meets, and they want to do it for their school. So for me, it's stressful, but they want to go out there and do their best. So you can see that they do work hard, and it means a lot to them.
All right, one last question. Recently, we heard some news about Noah Lyles having one of the biggest contracts since Usain Bolt. What do you think about that? How do you feel like that is for the sport?
For me, it's good. I can always love that because track and field is one of the smallest sports, you know what I mean? So I would love to see it get bigger and more money being pouring into it. So Noah is a person that shows a lot of character. So for me, it's good for him, and I know he's gonna do great things in the future.
cleaned up after the boat. Tommy and I are running late. We're heading over to the innovation lab right here with everybody else.
At the innovation lab, Puma introduced us to their decades-long connection with Jamaica. And they brought in coach Reynaldo Walcott, who coaches Elaine Thompson-Herah, and Alfred Francis, who was in charge of youth development in Jamaica when Usain Bolt was coming through the system. They set the table for us and helped us understand the stakes for champs, the pride, the performances, and the development of the next generation of Olympic greats.
It'll be a huge cultural moment because this is the future generation of athletes who all have one dream, one aspiration to become like Jaden, to represent their country at one of the biggest events globally at the Olympics.
Champs has evolved as really the centerpiece of Jamaica's track and field. All our great athletes have participated at Champs. All our great athletes have, you know, prepared themselves for this great phenomenon.
With a small country, a small demographic, almost everybody knows everybody. So when I was growing up, the poster girl, the poster lady for us was Mary Patty. And everybody knew of Mary Patty, even if you didn't know what she looked like, because some of us, we didn't have TV at the time, but we still knew about her. She would have been in our books at school. So we can attribute success to somebody who doesn't feel very far away.
After another short bus ride, we're at the restaurant. We're all gonna get some food now. Can't wait, I'm starving. It is 6 a.m. here on a Friday in Jamaica. We are now at the Usain Bolt Blue Track.
After Usain Bolt set the world record at the World Championships in Berlin in 2009, a track was built in Jamaica that would be an exact replica. Blue track, white stripes, 8 lanes.
The warm-up is run 60 meters?
Yeah.
Fast? All right.
That was 4?
Normally.
3.
I don't
one
start
more and then
my warm-up with strides,
but... You're doing 4 total.
It's so hot here. Don't really need a warm-up. I can just get right into it.
Puma essentially put on a fantasy camp for us, with triple jump specialist Jaden Hibbert and coach Michael Frater teaching us how to do drills. Olympic champion Hansley Parchment giving some hurdle coaching, 200 meter legend Elaine Thompson-Herah teaching us how to run the curve, and 100 meter Olympian Johan Blake teaching us how to explode out of the starting blocks.
Watching a world class triple jumper doing drills and plyos.
Fueled by nitrous.
Oh, amazing.
It must be you're ready. I'm the explosion. Be a target. Be explosion. Be a target. Be explosion. Be a target. Be explosion. Be a target.
Just got some lessons on blocks and starting from the 200 from one of the best in the world. It's incredible. Last up, we're gonna do some 100 meter block starts.
So, this is where it all starts. Lean forward, single command set.
We got a little bit of kind of open content creation time. There's new spikes over here people are testing out. I don't think I'm gonna do spikes. I think I'm gonna hurt myself if I try to get in some spikes today. But I do have a workout on the schedule. I'm trying to squeeze that in if I can. 8 times, 2 minutes on, 1 minute off. 10K pace on this beautiful track. A I'll see you.
Good boy.
Rope number 5, it's getting hot. Thanks, Tommy.
While we wait for the last
two, appreciate that.
We were running short on time, so I could only run 2 laps for a cool down. But I was thankful for every minute I had on this track. It's easily one of the top 5 tracks I've ever run on.
Guys, that was a thrilling bus ride. Now to get to lunch. Check out this view.
We had a large group for this trip, so I'm not sure how representative the catering menus were of actual Jamaican food. I'm also a pescatarian, so I didn't get to have any of the jerk chicken or barbecue pork we were served, but I did have a lot of ackee, which is a mushy dish with saltfish. And this lunch had mashed potatoes, mac and cheese, rice, veggies, fish, and curried chickpeas. It was all quite nice, especially the chickpeas.
That was a wonderful lunch. Really hot though, so tired. And I took a nap on the bus ride down here, but we're back down to sea level. We're here at Tuff Gong, Bob Marley's first studio.
Now for those who say that they cannot sing, this is not that tour. This is the tour where you guys are going to go inside the studio, record a Bob Marley song, and we're going to airdrop that song to you. We're going to sing this one. We know it's a little easy for everyone to know. So it goes a little bit like this. Don't worry about a thing now, because every little thing is gonna be alright.
Got a little bit of time before dinner, so I'm gonna try to hop on the treadmills because they don't want us wandering off campus here. Let's see if I get some miles in. All right, done with the elliptical for today. Now, last thing to do, have some dinner with everybody. Good morning. It is about 6:30 a.m. here in Kingston. Saturday, I think. I'm gonna go for a run today. New spot. It's absolutely gorgeous. We convinced them to let us go for a little bit longer today, so I'm gonna get 90 minutes here. Take a quick pit stop. This is beautiful out here. long run crew is here. Look at this, we're getting it in. Each lap is 1.62 miles. We've done two laps so far.
What's up, boys?
Looking good.
How we feeling?
Good? Heading into lap four now. Picked up Pedro, Maurice. Ooh, we got a nice headwind, which normally I wouldn't like, but it's so hot here. This headwind feels great.
Get him warm now, right? Nice.
That's right, sure.
Good job, guys.
All right, one more lap, and that'll be pretty good for today.
Extra power.
That's right, we need it. Now we got a tailwind. Finishing up our last lap here. Feels so good out. What a great day.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. We got time for one more or we head on the bus?
Woo. No, you got time.
Peer pressured everyone to doing another lap. None of these guys want to run another one, but I made them.
Yeah, I'm not tired.
All right.
They called it a quick one as well.
You know what, guys, when Puma told me they bring me to Jamaica and some fast BYU grads that I know would be here, I really thought Rory was gonna be here, but I got Adam instead.
Well done, guys.
These guys are so much faster than me. We've been waiting to get back into the innovation lab over there. I think we're gonna be able to see some really cool stuff. I think some of it I might not be able to show you quite yet, but I think a lot of it I will be able to. I think we'll be able to meet a couple more athletes as well, so should be exciting. Coming right up.
Boys and Girls Championship is the greatest high school championship in history. You know, that's where not all Jamaicans you get to see all their talents from all different types. And I think it's really, really amazing just by being in the stadium. You feel like you're at the Olympic Games. We call it the mini Olympic in Jamaica. So it definitely is really, really important, especially to be sitting and watching all the talented young athletes coming up. So definitely, if you're not at the Boys and Girls Championship, then you're missing a lot.
And then one last question. I've seen when the Jamaican relay team comes out, you're in front of the screen, you've got the swagger. Who comes up with the choreography? Who decides, here's what we're going to do when we come out there?
Depending. Sometimes, probably Shelly, sometimes with the name. You know, for me personally, I can't dance. So therefore, basically, they want to do a dance. I'm like, okay, then. Because sometimes, it's depending if the dance is good and I'm not then catching within the span of a week, you know. So I definitely know sometimes it's who dictate, like, oh, what we want to do or who know the dance better than they do it, and I just want to.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time.
Have fun. We have an 18-month development life cycle, and there's two phases in there that we wear, test the product. And I mean, we obviously have our strategy that we create in the boardroom, but then we take it out of the boardroom and we go visit these athletes as soon as possible with the first prototypes. And I think this speed suit is maybe a good example of how we worked with Rochelle.
Yes. So initially, I tried it and I loved it, but there was just a little tweaking that needed to be done. The cut was not so much comfortable, and I voiced my opinions and they went back and made it comfortable for me to wear.
A little bit higher
in the cut so that it sits in the right places. So when I hurdle, it won't move away from, you know, places.
Makes sense.
It's very detail oriented.
It was really exciting to work with them, especially on something like this, which is such a statement piece. Cutouts at the sides. We have the Jamaica written right at the waist. We wanted to make sure that this was a comfortable piece for them to wear while also giving you that striking visual.
So with the design of the speed suits,
there's another Puma athlete who very famously always tries to rip his open after he runs the 400 hurdles. Do you then try to design this new speed suits to rip open or to not rip open, even if Carson Warholm wants to rip them open?
So our zippers are lock zippers.
Okay.
So the zipper does not come undone. And this is made on purpose, because you don't want to be running and sprinting and then the zipper comes undone. Yeah. So it's like a seat belt, you know? So the more you will pull it, the less likely it's going to go down. So when Carsten did this at the Tokyo Olympics, we were thinking, no, the more you rip it, the more it's going to resist it. So no, we told him, now you know that this is like the seatbelt technology. The more you rip it, the more it's going to get stuck on the top. So it's just going to start ripping here. And you have to be careful, because it's going to go south somewhere. So now he knows, and he's done a lot of ripping sessions to make sure that he does it right.
The second changeover, Heidel and Edwin Allen continue on their mirror on Heidel. Edwin Allen is chasing and closing. St. Jago is coming forward, but Heidel in the lead. They make the change good, and they go now on the outside alpha. What a race they're having. Look at home with technical. Heidel, Edwin Allen, alpha will take second. Points gained for Heidel.
That was a mixed relay, 4x50. Principals, like high school principals, and sponsors. Now, we're gonna walk us around the track. Can you imagine being on a high school 4x1 team, running a 40.10 and not winning?
And not winning. Dude, it's crazy. It's crazy.
That's wild. It's so ridiculous.
Wow.
I've been fortunate enough to attend a couple of international track meets now. And Champs is unlike anything I've ever experienced. So much potential and so much passion. This is a place where Olympic dreams are born and cherished. And based on what I've seen at Champs, Jamaica's future is very, very bright.